It must be. What are you laughing for?
It's just so upset.
And then, Mr. Pitt. You're not Mr. Pitt. I don't even know why I said that. That's like my teacher. That's like, I actually have a teacher at school called Mr. Pitt. And do you know what's very cool? I've just been outside saying Brad to everyone. And that felt nice. It was a fun thing. I actually probably would start this by saying that I actually didn't know. This was a very late call up for me. And I actually didn't know what I was coming in to watch. And I went in. And I think this is probably the purest critique you can possibly get, because someone genuinely didn't have a clue what was going to happen. It's one of the best films I've ever watched.
Oh, that's great, mate.
I'm sure loads of people might just say that. I mean every second of it. I literally went in not having a clue. And
I love that. Thank you.
I think it's...
That's the best way to go into...
Mate, it could have been a horror for all I knew, mate. And I went in and sat down. I was like, oh my God. It made me miss the 20s, even though I was nowhere near born in the 20s.
I know exactly how you feel.
And I'm wondering whether that was like something that you wanted. Do you want to sort of have people pining for a long lost time?
Yeah. I mean, you have a friend who was born then.
Yeah. I mean, George Clooney talks about his early days in the 20s. But no, you speak pretty eloquently about that time. Pretty eloquently, not fully.
Yeah.
No, about that time being the Wild Wild West and unregulated.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's the thing also is, yeah, there's a weird misperception, I think, about the 20s. I remember growing up, you know, hearing about the Roaring 20s and it was wild. But then I would sort of look at depictions of the wildness and it would feel very quaint by today's standards. Yeah. You know, it's sort of, it was all martinis and Charlestons and flapper dresses. And, you know, at a certain point, that became kind of limiting. And the reality, of course, is that there was some of that, but there was so much more. And there was, a kind of sexual freedom that I don't think people realize, drugs on the scene that, in a way that people don't realize, a kind of, especially in early Hollywood, a sort of recklessness to just how work was done, how people worked, partied, lived.
People just dead on the set.
I was just going to say deaths, you know, and it was this mix of like absurdist comedy, tragedy, you know, horror, beauty, glamour. It was all mixed into this cauldron that was early Hollywood. And so that's kind of what we, I think, wanted to capture in this film.
Do you feel, Brad, that's why it feels weird saying it. Sorry, mate. Do you feel like we're in very different industries, but I suppose it's the same entertainment industry, right? The further on it goes, the more mundane it becomes in terms of the industry.
Oh, yeah, you got to do things behind closed doors if you're going to have fun. But, you know, there's more, I think there's more responsibility, yeah. There's more money on the line, you know, I mean, that's it. You got to be responsible to the people that are paying the bill, in a sense. So I worked with an actor once, and he was always late, 15 minutes, 40 minutes, hour and a half. And they added up at the end what it cost the film, and it was millions of dollars, several millions of dollars, people sitting and waiting around. So I think about it differently, and I think about in that. But it is certainly much more PC than we hear about this time, or the late 60s, early 70s, which it's much more PC.
Does it make you miss a time that you weren't even like alive for?
Yeah, I would like to. I mean, it would be fun to dabble in that for a moment. I don't know, you know, as long as you got out alive, which was yeah. Questionable.
That's what I would add, yeah.
It was a little wilder when I started, though, before camera phones and everything was recorded.
Do you miss it?
No.
Yeah, I miss it.
No, I'm old now. What do I care? Like, I did.
I miss it, mate. I wasn't even there.
Yeah, fair enough.
But it does get sadder, right? Because at the start of the film, it's literally like, I'm literally sitting there going, this is unbelievable. Yeah, get me there now.
Yeah.
And then as it goes on, you're like, oh, times are changing. And you know, sound comes into movies and all of that change. And have you ever seen things change in the movie industry just about how you record it and how you film it?
Not quite to that extreme, but yes, in the sense of, you know, so much is relied on, computers and, you know, CG, green screens. And Damon was really intent on not doing it that way. So when you see the 700 extras in the background explosion, that's all real. That's all in camera. Real. That's what we call practical. And that was great fun to do that again. But when I started out, it was that. Mm-hmm. I guess I saw that in the 90s, there was a rise of independent cinema, which kind of harkened back, I think, to the late 60s, when they were pushing back like Bonnie and Clyde against the studios. Now we have streamers. That's been the biggest upheaval. But I think it's actually a great thing. More and more talent is getting opportunities. There's There's things that wouldn't get seen or getting eyes on them on the streamers. And then there's still room, you know, for the big cinema dogs. Experience. And this one is definitely one of those.
Mate, it's an absolute, it's a banger.
It's great. Loved it, mate. That's great. I agree. It's an experience.
I love your ring, by the way, mate.
Thanks.
That's a hefty, ring. I've got one more thing. I've got it's basically poetry day very soon. And I've got a poem.
There's a poetry day. I didn't
even
know.
Is that England,
the thing in the UK? Okay. Poetry day? I love that.
It's written on my phone.
Why don't we have a poetry day?
Because
we're Yankees.
This is how I view the film. Really nervous.
All right. Okay. No, let's go, man. Let's go.
Dry mouth. I wish there was some water here.
Let's go.
Spitting dust over it. Okay. It's me. Hi. I'm the problem. It's me. At tea time, everybody agrees. I'll stare directly at the sun, but never in the mirror. It must be. What are you laughing for?
This is so sad.
It must be exhausting.
Wait, can I ask you, is hi H-I or H-I-G-H?
Hi isn't hello.
Okay. I'm going H-I-G-H.
Hi.
Okay.
I'm the problem, it's me. At tea time.
Oh, we're starting over, aren't we? Oh, no.
Everybody agrees. I'll stare directly at the sun, but never in the mirror. It must be exhausting, always rooting for the anti-hero.
I think that's a Taylor Swift song.
No? You know.
Isn't it?
Oh, you caught the play.
How do you know Taylor?
Is it really?
It's a part of it, and then I mixed it. Yeah.
Is it really?
I was trying to be funny. Oh, yeah, I thought you were just being your old funny self.
Wow.
You're smashing it.
I like that Taylor Swift, though. That's for certain. So
that's great. Thank
maybe,
you so much.
Maybe I just gravitated that way.
I absolutely love it. It's absolutely everything that I look for in a movie.
I feel the same. Thank you. Experiential.